Today we're going to talk a little bit about glyphosate. Glyphosate is another very, very commonly used herbicide in the area. Been around since the mid-70s. The active ingredient in Roundup, and the patent has long ago expired, and so there are a lot of generics out there. Glyphosate is a non-selective herbicide. It basically, when it was designed, to kill any kind of plant that you put it on. Some plants have developed a resistance to glyphosate now, and that's developed a whole new market out there. The way glyphosate works is it is absorbed into the green tissue of plants, and it moves throughout the plant and will kill the entire plant. It works best on plants when they're actively growing. If you're in the middle of a drought and plants are not growing very quickly, glyphosate is not taken up very well by the plant. So it's a good idea if you're trying to kill a plant with glyphosate, fertilize it first so that it's actively growing, and then you can go ahead and finish it off with glyphosate. Okay, this is an example of glyphosate. The patent ran out on Roundup several years ago, so now there are several different generic formulations available. This particular formulation is Roundup, and it is ready to use. It's already mixed up for you. So if you want to use this, be sure, or I'd wear rubber gloves if I use this type of sprayer. Be sure you shake the material up good. You want to make sure that the surfactant that's in the Roundup is mixed with the active ingredient, glyphosate. The way this product works, it is a non-selective herbicide, which means it will kill pretty much anything that you put it on. It is absorbed by green tissue, the leaves or the leaf blades, and it translocates to the roots and it kills the plant. So with that in mind, and this is the example of a flower bed that has some Bermuda grass encroaching on the flower bed, I'm going to go in here, and if I get any spray out here on this Bermuda grass, it can injure it, probably will injure it. So I'm going to be very careful, and I'm going to direct my spray only to the Bermuda grass that is in the bed that I want to kill. And I'm going to try not to get it on the Bermuda grass that's out here. On the same vein, I can get it on this bark and it won't be a problem because that's not green tissue. So I'm not going to worry about getting it on the bark. However, I will be very careful not to get any on this little piece of a leaf here because that is green tissue and it can translocate from that to the rest of the tree. But that is the way you use Roundup. If you have weeds out in the Bermuda grass that you want to kill, you can treat, like for example, here we have a little broadleaf plant that we want to kill, and I'm going to direct the spray to that. Now, I will kill this, and I may kill a little bitty spot of Bermuda grass right here, but Bermuda grass will go back into that spot very quickly.